Hi YouTube, this is a free extract from my larger Illustrator Advanced course. You can check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Also, there's a link in the description for the exercise files. Those are free to download, so go and download those. All right, enjoy the video. Hey there, it's shadow time. We are going to do three kinds of shadows. We are going to do lame drop shadows, we're going to do flat shadows, and then we're going to do some fady shadows. All very technical names. Let's go and learn how to do those now in Adobe Illustrator. All right, you can use obviously any object. If you want to play along, open up shadows.ai from the exercise files. Okay, and there's three kinds of shadows, right? There is this just typical drop shadow, so I've selected it all. Over here under effects, and there's one under stylize, there's one called drop shadow. If you're using an older version of Illustrator, it's under effects, stylize. Okay, turn preview on and you get amazing drop shadow. Okay, it's not amazing. Often I turn it right down when I'm using it, kind of something really small and low, just kind of give it a bit of depth. Okay, let's say we want a long shadow and we'll just do a long hard shadow and then we'll do a soft shadow. Okay, I'm going to make a duplicate down here so I can come back to him. And what I'd like to do is I'm going to pick a background color. So actually I'm going to use the eyedropper tool and pick the background so he's the same color. I'm going to go to fill and just darken it down a bit. You can see I'm using the HSB. Okay, I find them easier to use. It's going to make it a little darker. And yeah, next thing we're going to do is we're going to move it down a little bit. So we're going to go object, transform each. It just means I can move it down one pixel, across one pixel. This means it's going to go to the right and down. You can go negative one and negative up and it will go up and left. Okay, so do that, click on copy. And it just made one, so we've got two versions of it now. I'm in wireframe mode, Command Y on a Mac, Control Y on a PC. I'm gonna go back out, Command Y. Okay, and I'm just gonna repeat that. So the shortcut is Command D, the long way is somewhere, there it is, transform again. So just do that thing I just did again. And you can see, I just step it out. Now you'll see that there's a little bit of an edge on it. Okay, so if you want there to be less edge, there's just no way real around other than drawing it, okay, to get an edge. Now what you can do is we did type transform each and we did 1 point. You can do 0.1. The only trouble is that it's gonna take a while. Okay, because I'll show you what I mean. Command D is the repeat, remember? Control D on a PC. I'm holding the key down and it's even taking a while. So I'll get the editor to speed it up. All right, didn't take that long, but long enough. Okay, so that's our shadow, right? Okay, we're gonna grab this. I'll show you how to fix it up, but this is basically all we do, okay? You do them in smaller increments if you've got the time and you're not worried and you're more worried about the edge. I'm probably worried about it enough to maybe turn it down to half a point. Next thing we wanna do is probably trim it all up, because at the moment, if I go to Command Y, it's a bit of a mess in terms of its vector. So what I'll do is I'll grab this, undo him. You go back to where you were, to join this all up. And we've been using the Shape Builder tool throughout this course. If you click on the Shape Builder tool now, it's gonna have a seizure. Okay, it just doesn't like so many shapes. So we're gonna use the more traditional Pathfinder. If you can't see it over here, I've got it selected all of this with my black arrow. You go to Window Pathfinder. I'm gonna click on this first option, Unite. And it's still gonna take a while. Okay, not as long as Pathfinder. And if you've got more, say you've done 0.1, okay, to get it really nice and smooth on the edge, it's gonna take forever. Go get a coffee. Oh yeah, let's speed this up. All right, barely need to speed that up. Other thing I might do is, I'm gonna grab this, grab my rectangle tool, I'm gonna drag it out so it matches the pasteboard. And I'm gonna now, because it's all united, now I can work with my Shape Builder tool. Shift M, remember? Okay, and I'm gonna delete that chunk and that chunk and that chunk and just kind of make it look a little nicer. I drew a bad rectangle, but you get the idea, right? Send him to the back. All right, so that's one way with a hard shadow. Let's do a soft shadow. We're gonna look at blending modes. Now we're gonna kind of just touch on blending modes now. We're gonna look at blending modes in its full entirety in a section in this course. But for the moment, let's do it for the shadow. So I'm gonna make a copy of this guy down the bottom here. Okay, copy even. Holding Alt while I'm dragging it. Okay, so there's a couple of things I need to do is I need to change the color of both of these and then group them before I start moving on. So first of all, I want to grab my eyedropper tool, pick the background color, and I want it to be a slightly darker version, right? And I'm going to now hold down my Alt key on a PC, Option key on a Mac, and drag the second version. Cool, but I want him to actually be the exact background color. So it's not going to really fade out with opacity. That doesn't work. Okay, we need to just match the background color. So next step is I got them the right colors, but they need to be groups. Okay, so they're all separate. So I need to go, you, my friend, is a group. Command G, okay, on a Mac, or Control G on a PC to group them. And the other thing is that this guy needs to be at the front because it's going to be heading backwards. At the moment, he's the second guy that got made, so he's at the front and it looks a bit weird. So you, my friend, arrange, bring to front. Cool. So they're grouped, they're the right colors, and they're in the right order. Now we just blend them. Okay, so under Object, we go to Blend and we say Make. And by default, you just get one guy in the middle. We need to increase that blend. Okay, so we're going to go to Object, Blend, and we're going to go to Blending Options. And in here, we're going to go to Specific Steps. So how many steps in between? At the moment, we've got one, and the higher it is, the kind of nicer the edge, but the more stressed out your computer is going to be. So play around. This will really depend on your artboard size and how far apart things are. Turn on Preview, and let's test 100. Okay, and you can see it's quite jaggedy at the edge, like we did here. How high? 300 is looking pretty smooth. Okay, let's click OK. Let's click off in the background. And there's our shadow. Okay, so let's add this guy back on. Come back, buddy. All right, bring him to the front. And yeah, that's it. A couple of things you might want to do is at the moment this is like an active blending mode, which means I can do things like this. I can double click it to go inside. I'm in isolation mode. I click on this one guy at the bottom and I can just move it around depending on kind of how I want this thing to look. Okay, and to get back out, I just double click the background. Next thing I might do is I might want to expand it because this is like an active effect. Okay, I can go to Object, go to Expand, and to see, well, Object Blend, sorry, and say Expand, and it just kind of turns it into all those shapes. And we can't smush it down like we did this other one because they're all different transparencies, so it's a little bit problematic that way. But let's say I want to trim it now. You could do it, trim it, whether using blending modes or expanding like we did here. Okay, I'm going to select you, and grab you, and I'm just going to hold Command 7 on a Mac, Control 7 on a PC, and just send it to the back. And there we go. Okay, it's all trimmed up and nice and ready to be exported for whale stuff. All right, anyway, let's move on to the next videos. That's it for shadows. Hey there, I hope you liked it. If you did, give me a thumbs up. It really helps out what I do. I've got lots of other stuff here on YouTube, so consider subscribing. Also, I want to see what you made. Okay, so you're obviously doing something. Don't be shy. I'd love to see what it is. If you put it up on Instagram, I'd love to, yeah, for you to mention me. I'm Bring Your Own Laptop on Instagram. And on Twitter, I'm Dan Loves Adobe. Also, if you like my teaching style and you know you want more advanced Illustrator stuff, there's the full course. Okay, it's on bringyourownlaptop.com. There'll be a link in the description. Also on Bring Your Own Laptop is there's a resources tab and there's a free cheat sheet in there. Free, totally downloadable. It has all the kind of, we did the keyboard shortcuts and stuff for Illustrator. It's a PDF, you print it off, stick it next to your computer. It's awesome. All right, continue on. Bye now.